many are rejoicing and happy to be here this morning. Through it all, man. This is the end of, almost the end, the last few days, few hours in July. Coming to prepare to come into the August. Coming ready to come into abundance. Coming ready to come into a new beginning. Wave your hands if you are ready here. Come on, let me have a witness. Hallelujah. Lord, prepare to be a sanctuary, pure and whole, to joy and truth, with thanksgiving. I'll be only sanctuary. Oh, I'll take it again. So Lord, breathe to be a sanctuary.
built by bricks
and with the hands of man. Amen. That was long ago. He doesn't live there anymore. You are the tabernacle of God. Amen. God lives in you now. Praise God. He lives in you. So you are the tabernacle we are talking about. Amen. Praise God. As I was coming up here, the Spirit ministered to me to bring a word for one particular person.
Amen.
You are here. You didn't sleep yesterday night. Existing that is troubling you. Can you please put John 14:1? That's the word God said I should give to you before I progress. John 14:1. Say, let not your heart be troubled. I don't know what is troubling you. I don't know who he is. Say, let not your heart be troubled. John 14:1, please. Just flash it. I want you to take that home. If you are the person, in as much as you are here, say, let not your heart be troubled. Whatsoever is troubling you today, whatsoever that situation was that made you not to sleep, God has remembered you. Say, let not your heart be troubled. Just believe in Jesus Christ. He's going to do that battle for you. I don't know who you are, but that was the word I received as I was coming up here. Praise God.
Amen.
I want to let us know that Jesus has done all that we need to succeed in life.
Amen.
He has done it all. Revelation 5 made us to understand scroll with seven seals. And there was none in heaven, here on earth, beneath the earth, none, no being at all, that was before, present, or that will come in the future, that was able to look into that seal. Amen. Into the scroll. Not to talk about opening the seal. And John wanted to cry. And one elder told him, relax. Wait for it. I don't know what is troubling you this morning. Relax. Jesus is coming.
Okay.
And the Bible proceeded and said, and Jesus came forth like a lamb that was slain. And everybody was quiet. And he was worthy. And he opened up the scroll.
Amen.
Amen. And there was rejoicing everywhere. In heaven. On earth. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And they were saying, oh, he was able to do it. He has given us identity. He has given you an identity. He has given you a kingdom. Praise God.
Amen.
He has transformed you from ordinary to extraordinary. He has transformed you from natural to the supernatural. Hey, he has transformed you from being a sinner to a living saint. He has transformed you from being a sickler to a healed. Amen. He has transformed you from beneath to above. I don't know what your situation is, but I'm here to let you know that this morning, that indeed he has done it.
Amen.
And what he has done, the Bible said none other was able to do it. He did it perfectly well. I'm here to talk about living the life of a supernatural being. Amen. Living a supernatural being. That is what Christ has come to do. And you know what? He came to do it for us. Amen. Not for him. He's already God. Whether we believe it or not, it doesn't matter. He's still God. He remains God.
Amen.
He said he is God all by himself.
Yes, Lord.
So it's better we believe it. Because he did it for us. Praise God. He has done it. So whatsoever you are going through this morning, I want you to know that he has done it. It's all for you to believe it. Praise God.
Amen.
All you just need to do is to believe.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
In John 1:12, he said, as many, John 1:12, please, I just want them to be making contact of the word.
Amen.
As many as receive him, even if you believe in that name, he has given you
to become the sons of God. Amen. Amen. That is Jesus for you. As many. It doesn't matter where you are coming from. It doesn't matter what you have been through. It doesn't matter what you have done. It's not important. It's irrelevant in this case. See, as many, as long as you receive him, as long as you believe in that name, you have been given the power to become the Son of God. Amen.
Amen.
That is the truth. Look at it there. He went further to expand this in 1 John 5:4. Amen. 1 John 5:4. He went further to try to explain it. He said, look, as long as you are the Son of God, you are what? More than conquerors. Amen.
Amen.
You are above. You are as long as you are the Son of God. He started from first. He started from John 1:12. Then he break it down in 1 John 5:4. Let's read. Say, for whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. Praise God. So you have overcome. You have overcome. Then in John 14:12, he gave us an illustration of what he expects from us. Amen.
Amen.
John 14:12. Because of one of time, I mean, not. What does he want? Or what is this transformation from natural to supernatural? He wants us to be like him. To do what he did when he was here on earth. That was the least. He said we are even supposed to do much more.
Yeah.
Amen. Maybe at your own time you go through it. The least we can do right now is what Jesus did when he was here. That is the power he has given to us. Amen.
Amen.
We know that he healed the sick. He cast out demons. He raised the dead. We know of Jairus' daughter. We know of Lazarus and many others. So the least he expects from you and me, amen, is to do what he did. But he did not stop there. He said he expects us to go beyond that, do much more, because I am going to my Father. Amen. He's going to his Father, so he's going to back us from there so that we'll be able to do much more. Amen.
Amen.
So it's very important that we live with this consciousness that we are no more ordinary. We are no more natural. You got to believe it. You got to live it. As I started to ponder further, he took me to a story in the Bible that has really pondered my heart for a long time. And that is seen in Mark 11. The story of Jesus and the fig tree. We all know the story, isn't it? Because I've been pondering, what exactly did this fig tree do? We know the story, so I don't want to go into that. What exactly? In fact, before the Holy Spirit revealed this to me, I went to do a research. And I came to the understanding that a fig tree produces twice every year. Every year. And the Bible says at that particular time that Jesus went to that fig tree, it was not his season. So the fig tree did not really do anything. But the Holy Spirit told me to tell his people that look, Jesus wants us to live exactly what happened here. He told me that Jesus went to that fig tree as a supernatural being. On getting to the fig tree, he expected a supernatural result, irrespective of the fact whether it was time for harvest or not. He expected a supernatural result. Because before the Spirit revealed to me, I used to bring it forth to say, but Solomon says in Ecclesiastes that it's time for planting and a time for harvest. But the Spirit let me know that that is a natural order. Amen. It's just a natural order. But we are no more operating under the natural order. We have been transferred to the supernatural order. So it doesn't matter anymore. So Jesus went to that fig tree as a natural being, expecting a supernatural result. And on getting there, he didn't see it. He did not leave it at that. He made a supernatural pronouncement. And the supernatural happened. The Bible said that fig tree dried from the root. Amen. It dried from the root. Amen. I don't know what you are going through. I don't know what you are facing. I don't know how you have been living your life. But please, you are not ordinary. You are not natural. Jesus came to transfer us. He came to take us from point A to point B. We must have that consciousness. You must live it out. You must live like Jesus. You must live what he has done for you. Amen.
Amen.
It's very, very, very important. Because some of us, we just fold our hands and let nature determine what will happen to us. No. No. I like the testimony my sister gave. She said, no. God, you got to do something about this, my son. You got to do something about this, my son. And that was exactly what happened. Stop allowing nature to determine what will happen to you.
Hallelujah.
It's no more what will happen. No, you are a Christian. You are a believer.
Yes.
Amen. You have the power to change things.
Yes,
you have the power. The power has been given to you. That was why Jesus Christ came to suffer everything he suffered.
Right.
It is not. He didn't suffer this so that we will re-elect him. He doesn't need your re-election. That is the truth about the matter. He doesn't need it. He did it for you. He did it for me. And it's high time we start living this life.
Amen.
We just have to start living it. Because it's wasting. It's wasting. I had the same issue some years back. Some people said, oh, we're not going to give birth. But just one day we decided. Went to pray, remained in the place of prayer. We left our house. And after some days, God answered us. Today we have 5 children.
Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Before, my wife, she was 6 months pregnant. The thing just disappeared. Wicked forces. Wicked and dangerous forces. She didn't believe. So it's high time we stand and say no. Not to certain things. That sickness that is ravaging your body is not of God. It is not of God. The Bible says God will not tempt you with bad things. It's not of God. You got to say no to it. That lack, that poverty is not of God. You got to say no to it. Whatsoever you are going through that is not of God, it's high time you stand up and say no. And heaven will hear. The earth will hear. Because you carry the Godhead inside of you. Praise God. So we got to change the way.